Hello, in this 10 minutes lecture series we will be discussing about group morale. Now let us first consider what individual morale is. Now before we enter into this discussion of morale, let me introduce myself. I am Gitendra Handa of GNKITM TC. And this is a 10 minutes lecture series for your examination. Now coming back to group morale, now first we should try and understand what individual morale is. Now individual morale is a single person's attitude towards work environment. Now let us understand what is group morale. Now this is individual's attitude towards their work and the environment. Group morale is the group's attitude towards the work and the environment. Morale is everybody's concern and may go on changing with the passage of time. Individual and group morale are interrelated and however they cannot be identical. They have an effect on each other. Now characteristics of group morale. Group morale is an intangible term. We cannot see a morale. Morale contributes to the willingness of the people to work. Group morale is a significant variable. It determines the success of an organization. People with high morale work willingly, enthusiastically in order to achieve organizational goals. Higher morale leads to efficiency, success, and positive outlook. Low morale leads to inefficiency, low productivity, and waste. Group morale has direct relationship with productivity. This is for sure. That means the higher the morale, the higher is the productivity. It has a positive relationship with productivity. Factors determining morale. Now, first is the objective of an organization. If the objective or the aim of the organization is clear cut and is defined to the workers, the morale is going to be high with the workers. Then is leadership. Effective leadership provides comfortable, satisfactory work environment. It plays a very important role in group morale building. Job satisfaction. If the job is satisfying, a person enjoys the task and this gives him opportunity to self-develop also, then he has high morale. Structure of the organization. If the authority and responsibility are clearly defined and there is a frank and free communication between the managers and the subordinates, such situation is highly conducive for morale building. Compensation. When fair compensation and reward are ensured for higher efficient people, then morale tends to be high. Living conditions of the workers are very healthy. Physical and mental health is taken care of, automatically their morale will be high. Working environment, satisfactory condition in the workplace have a direct impact on morale. Particularly in times of stress and controversy, the morale plays a very important role in lessening the strain. Let us see how. Now this was all about morale. Now how to improve the morale or ways of improving the morale. First is two-way communication. There should be two-way communication between the manager and the workers. Workers should be introduced with the policies and procedures of the organization, and he should feel free to get clear any doubts or grievances if he has with the organization or with the manager. Now this greatly enhances the morale of the organization. Human relation approach. Every individual should believe that no individual or group is better than the other, so that the contribution of each individual may be recognized and no one should be underestimated. Harmonious relationship should be developed among the employees. They should be given equal opportunity to develop themselves. Attitude of the management has a merry workers' attitude. In an organization, the line staff plays a great role in building the morale of the subordinates. Morale is as a result of effective direction by their supervisors. The supervisor should give a clear directions. In raising the morale, persuasive words are more effective than any kind of punishment. Persuasive words, kind words are very important for developing a high morale in an individual. Worker participation in management. Workers should be allowed to take part in decision-making activities where they are involved. They should be consulted. In organization, technique like joint consultation, collective bargaining are used. Organizational techniques like joint consultations and collective bargaining are important for increasing their enthusiasm, their morale, and removing the conflict. Job enrichment to give them more responsible and new challenging job. Financial and non-financial incentives. The greater financial and non-financial incentives can enhance their morale. Employees' welfare, great, looking into the welfare activities like housing, medical benefit, education for the children, canteen, sports, clubs, safety facilities, where these all are highly helpful in developing a positive attitude. The management should not encourage social activities among, should encourage social activities among workers to improve group cohesion, and group cohesion in turn results in high morale. Job security. Everyone wants to secure their future first. If an organization commits employees for securing their jobs, this will help in relaxing the employee and remove all sorts of tension. This will enhance their morale also. Now, group management can follow some other techniques also to improve the individual morale. Respect the individual. Set worthwhile goals. Provide good work environment. Adopt an open door policy. That means the transparent policy should be followed by the organization. Morale building techniques can be of two types. Individual techniques, we have talked about that. Then there can be group techniques. Group techniques concentrate in group attitudes, personal counseling, exit interviews, attitude surveys, job enrichments, group meetings, collective bargaining are some of the important group techniques to improve the employee morale. Attitude survey are done to check the reaction of the employees towards the job and towards the wage rate, and so that we can know if it's positive, he will have a greater morale. So attitude survey help in increasing the morale of the organization. Then we have employees having high following characters who have great morale. Now, express admiration towards their leader. Ensure any members who can bring discredit to the organization cooperate with one another. Have a low rate of absenteeism. Require no supervision. Display relaxed attitude. Make meaningful suggestions for improvement and have power to take the initiative. Perform their job with a positive outlook and always result in high productivity. Come to office early and stay late in order to complete their work. They never grudge, that is, they never complain or resent about anything of the organization. Now, this is all about the group morale. Thank you very much.